Hi guys, welcome back to another video and welcome to my channel if you're new. Hi, I'm Femke and in today's video I wanted to share with you how I made this super pretty like cherry blossom water decal design and also give you some tips and tricks on how to use them. Especially if you have longer nails like I do, these are my natural nails, it can be quite hard to use the regular like big sized full nail decals because for me these aren't like full nail ones, but for a lot of other people out there they are. So I'm going to give you some tips and tricks on how to use them if you do have longer nails. But first up, if you haven't subscribed yet, I would really appreciate it if you would do so. Hit that thumbs up and that gray notification bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video. I usually tend to upload like 3 to 4 times a week, but yeah, let's continue to the video. So the sheet of water decals that I'm using today is one that came of like a 25 or a 50 pack of all different decals. And of course, I have already added my base coat as well as a white layer of polish. I used both by Holo Taco and I had already applied that a day before recording this video. But what you are going to use in this particular design, or if you are going to apply some water decals, is a pair of scissors, some tweezers, of course your decal. I tend to use like a silicone tool, that's really nice to press it down, but I do tend to use my cleanup brush for that a lot as well. That one is quite dense and it just works wonders. So you do need a little cleanup brush and some nail polish remover or pure acetone to get rid of the excess decal. Of course, you are going to use a little dish with some water. I just use like regular tap water, not hot, not cold, just straight from the tap. Then you want to cut up the little water decal pieces, especially if you're using a sheet of decals like I'm doing here. I was just first of all measuring up if they would fit, if I would have like any excess, or maybe they were way too small. Like most of these usually are too small for my nails, but that is why I have applied a white layer on forehand, and also that really helps with letting the colors of the decals pop. I have mentioned this in my previous like how to use water decal video, that if you apply a light base, whether it's a white or a creamy color or whatever, it really makes the colors of the water decals pop. And if you use a darker color, it might mute the colors down a bit. But here you can see I was already still measuring up the decals. This one, I had a little trick for that one, because this one was really easy for me to just cut in half. So I could place it a little bit more like separated or sparsely, like compared to the other one. You will see what I mean with this in a little bit. So I'm just cutting it up, just making sure I make two smaller decals so I can place one more towards the cuticle area and one more towards the tip. And that is also a really great tip to actually use decals like these if they are too small for your nails, or maybe even too big and you can use one decal twice. But the most important step when using water decals is to remove the clear film. If you don't do that and you dunk it into the water, you won't be able to use your water decal and you just have to throw it out because it's pretty much useless at that point. But there are a lot of different types of water decals out there. This is just one from a bigger pack which I got at AliExpress. Another great tip, by the way, is just to go on AliExpress and see what kind of water decals they have. There are a ton out there and they're all so pretty and versatile and you can use them like any time of year, to be honest. They're really easy to use as well. But there are also water decals that don't have that clear film. So just check that on forehand before using it. Just make sure that you remove it if it's on there, and if not, you can just cut it up the way you want it, put it in the water, let it sit for like 20 seconds or something, and you can use it. I just tend to wait like 20 seconds before I get my decal out of the water, and it must be quite easy to slide off that backing paper. If it won't slide off easily, just dunk it back into the water for like 10 more seconds and it must come off easily, or at least more easily. Then with my tweezers, I just grab the decal and place it on my nail. As you can see here, because I left a little bit of that water on that decal, it was really easy to just slide it onto the nail and just place it wherever I want it. If you dry it off completely, it will stick right away. You won't be able to like slide it around or move it around on a nail. But to remove that excess water, because you don't want any water underneath your decal before you go in with your top coat layer, I just make sure to remove that with a little cotton round. You can just press that on it and you will get rid of all of that water that might be stuck underneath. Just press it just gently but a little bit firmly, like you don't want to like tear your decal, so just be quite gentle with it, but make sure that all of the water underneath the decal is completely gone. Then you can take your silicone tool or maybe even your finger, but I am going to use my cleanup brush because that one is quite firm to really make sure that the decal is pressed down flat onto the nails. There isn't any air or water bubbles underneath. And yeah, then it is actually time to clean up your edges. And I'm going to use that same brush for that and just a little bit of nail polish remover that contained acetone. You can use pure acetone for this. It's totally up to you what you want to use. It's just like what's your personal preference, I'd say. I just used some nail polish remover that contained acetone. Like acetone was the number one ingredient, so this works pretty nicely as well. Just be gentle with it. Press down the edges around the cuticle area really well before doing this, because otherwise you might lift up the entire decal off of the nail and you don't want that. But the excess decal is really easy to remove. Just press it gently with your brush and a little bit of nail polish remover and you're good to go. Let's continue with the next nail. So once again, remove the clear film and dunk it in water for 20, maybe 30 seconds. It can sometimes depend on the brand or what type of decal you're using, how long you have to dunk it into the water. I do have some other like decals that don't have that clear film that you only have to put in the water for like 10 to 15 seconds. So yeah, it really depends and just go for it. Just try it out. There's nothing wrong with just experimenting a little bit. And here was Timmy, one of my tuxedo cats, just running on my table where I was working and just putting his face into everything as usual. That's also the reason why there are sometimes like cat hairs in view, in screen, stuck to my hands, stuff like that. That just happens when you have two cats that are quite curious. But oh well, back to the video, because I had just soaked my decal for like 20 seconds and I'm going to place it on the nail again. The reason I already kind of explained why I use a white polish is that it really makes the colors of the decals pop, but for these decals, since they are too small for the length of my natural nails, I really wanted to use a white because it was exactly the same white tone as the background of these decals. Now I haven't applied the top coat. You can still see the edge of the decal on the tip of my nail a bit, but that will be completely gone once I've added a nice layer of top coat that really smooths in that little line and it won't be visible at all anymore. So yeah, that is just another little quick tip. So white polishes, that's like a standard thing that I would recommend any nail polish loving girl or guy to have in their collection. I just used one by Holo Taco. This is like the Not Milky White. I did have to say that it's not better than one of the Essence polishes that I have. Like the white by the Essence Shine Less Than Go collection is so good. It is insane. But this one is more expensive and a little bit more thick, a little bit more hard to work with. But with two coats, it was completely opaque. And yeah, that's that. So you can just use any white polish. It doesn't have to be one by Holo Taco. You can just use any brand you have around. But yeah, sometimes it can be a little bit hard to get rid of that like clear film. Just keep on like wiggling it a little bit and I'm sure you will get it off. Also, if you have longer nails like I do, it can be a little bit hard to just peel them off. You can use your tweezers for that as well. Like, tweezers is one of the only things I'd say you really need when using water decals, because it just works so much easier than if you would have to like peel it off with your fingers or your nails or something like that. But yeah, here you can see I actually like messed it up a little bit. I just applied it way too sloppy. But the cool thing is that if there is a little bit of water still underneath there, you can just smooth it out really easily and you won't like have to redo your entire nail. You don't have to apply a new decal. So this was already like halfway through the entire video, I have to say. But for this middle finger, I used the two, or at least the one, cut up decal, but then in two little stages. You can easily overlap decals as well. I'm going to do that for just a little bit right here. As you can see, in the middle of the nail, the two decals actually overlap a bit. Again, you won't be like able to see that once you've added your top coat. And yeah, just make sure you really press them down gently but firmly enough that there isn't any air or water underneath, because if there is, your decal will definitely come off, maybe even break apart or something like that. But yeah, just clean up all of the excess decal afterwards once you're sure that your decal is in place, like put and not moving anymore. And I'm just going to quickly add the two other decals to my ring finger as well as my pinky. And can I just say, let's all take a moment to appreciate how pretty these like cherry blossoms, sakura blossoms are. They're so beautiful. Like, I really want to go back to Japan in like the cherry blossom season. I think that's like in March or something like that. I really hope to go there like once again. I've already been to Japan, to Tokyo last November, which was so cool. I loved it there so much. But yeah, I really want to go back in spring once again. So yeah, I really, really love these decals. They're so beautiful and I got them at AliExpress. I'm not quite sure from what seller I got them, but there are a ton of different ones out there. So if you're curious about that, just go on AliExpress, search on water decal or water decal nail art or something like that, and I'm sure you will find what you're looking for. Then for the top coat, I'm going in with the Glossy Taco by Holo Taco. I really like it. It's nothing really special or spectacular in my opinion, but that is just because I have tried so many top coats from like way less expensive brands, like drugstore brands, that I'm not quite impressed that easily, I have to mention. But yeah, just add your top coat. You can use any top coat. You can use a matte top coat as well, but I would suggest to just go in with a glossy one first, because sometimes matte top coats can kind of like mess up your decal. I've only had that once, and ever since I'm never going in straight away with a matte top coat anymore. So yeah, that's just a little quick tip. Just apply your favorite glossy top coat first, and if you want to make it a matte design, just throw on a matte top coat after your glossy one has fully dried. But of course, make sure to cap off the edges as well, so your manicure lasts a long period of time. And I have to mention, at the moment I'm still wearing this design. I've worn it for a full week already, and I really don't want to take it off yet, but I know I have to because I have to record new cool design videos for you guys. But I really hope you like this video. If you have any questions regarding applying water decals like this, let me know in the comments down below. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I love you so much. Stay safe and healthy, and let me know if you're going to try some water decals yourself, and I hope to see you in one of my next videos.